The Winnemem elders stayed strong throughout the last century. Leaders such as Alfred Gillis and Florence Jones were at the forefront of a statewide campaign to sue the federal government because of the 18 broken treaties in California. And in 1946, Congress set up a commission to settle land claims.
And in the winning of that lawsuit, we also won the recognition of being Indians eligible for services and benefits from the United States in the taking of our lands, which included health, education, housing, jobs, that kind of thing.
But in the 1980s, for most of California's tribal people, a new label, unrecognized, erased those hard-won compensations. The Bureau of Indian Affairs had created a list of recognized tribes which the agency would continue to deal with, and thousands of people whose tribes were not on the list were suddenly denied services, benefits, and protections.
Now we're sitting in a position where we're unheard and unseen as an unrecognized tribe. And so we're like, had a brief period between the 70s and the 80s where it was not illegal to practice our religion. We use eagle feathers in our dance, in our prayers, and it's an integral part. You have to have a permit to hold eagle feathers, and they revoked that from Winnemem.
It's from the Fish and Wildlife Service, stating that the Winnemem went to, you are not affiliated with a federally recognized tribe. Oh, they're a little late in finding out. It's like 25 years.
It's also education. You know, in 1978, I graduated high school and got a Bureau of Indian Affairs higher education grant. In 1989, when I tried to go back, I'm no longer eligible for those services. Here I am, Indian from when I was born to 1986. They counted me. I was an enrolled California tribal member. I have an Indian roll number. But now I'm no longer eligible for those services.
They're telling me that I don't know my ways. I don't know who my people are. I don't, you know, my father, my mother, they're also Native. They're Winnemem. They're saying that they're not Winnemem. Their mothers and fathers before that, they're saying they're not Winnemem because I'm not, and those are all my blood relatives.
There should not be any unrecognized Indians in California because we have the judgment roll that goes back to 1850, before California became a state. And every descendant thereof is a recognized Indian and had been up until the 1980s. That terminology should never be allowed to exist this day and age with human rights and the rights of indigenous people to continue to exist.